couple of days, we haven't been allowed access into the building to assess the damage. I know we got a lot of concerned customers for the merchandise. We believe the jewelry and the guns are going to be fine because they're in a 12-foot concrete vault with an actual bank door like First National would have. But the general merchandise, it's pretty obvious. If you look at the building, there's going to be a lot of damage. We'll replace that merchandise with light merchandise, and we're going to take care of our customers and be fair. We're going to try and reopen on the same property, but in a warehouse, which we're fitting right now with alarms and security and vaults and everything you need to operate a pawn shop. And we're hoping to be open Wednesday at the best, Friday at the worst. And our new hours will be 10 to 6, Monday through Friday. And I have a temporary hotline they can call. It's 254-953-5353, extension 236. And I have somebody ready at that phone right now. That'll be there 10 to 6 today, tomorrow, Monday, Tuesday, until we get our normal lines hooked up in the new place we're going to operate.
Okay.
The city was good enough to take care of us on the permits and expedite things where we could have a temporary place to operate. And we're going to rebuild bigger and better than we were. Actually, I was on top of the building and looked inside and saw items that weren't touched at all by the fire, which was surprising. And no heat, no smoke. It's like any kind of disaster. It's just some certain things get spared, some don't. But no smoke, no heat. And I was sitting there waiting for some paperwork from the city, and so the fire trucks came up. I didn't even realize that he reached our team, which is, I think, the third. We had the original fire, a flare-up the next day at noon, and then today's flare-up. So we have, that's our excavator there, and we're pulling that wall up so we can get it out once and for good, so we can safely go in there and do what we need to do to get our stuff out. And we're going to have police or sheriff's departments on site until we get with ATF on Tuesday and account for all the fire. It looks like a lot of our retail pistols are intact, but our main concern is the customer. So, you know, if all our retail is gone, we can recover. You know, the customer stuff is the stuff we're concerned about preserving, replacing, protecting. They never did give us a final determination. I do believe they said that, for the record, that it wasn't arson, which we didn't feel it was arson. But as far as, and they even narrowed down the southeast quadrant of the building is where the fire started. We don't know what happened because we have no power on the night there. So it's kind of real hard to say how it started there or why. We did have laptops there. And there are some laptops that even turned off, the batteries were combust. And one ATF agent actually said that there was a huge recall on laptops, and he thought it was in the laptop area. But I don't know if they'll ever be able to find that laptop and say this laptop battery blew up and caught on fire.